one education.
Fellow Namibians, irrespective of where you find yourself, irrespective of where you find yourself today, across the length and breadth of our republic, this day, 21st March, marks an important milestone in the birth of our democracy and national identity. As we reflect on the past traverse, we have covered significant ground together. We have matured in our constitutional democracy. We are stronger, more resilient, and determined to prevail in the second phase of our struggle, that of economic emancipation. Indeed, we have come of age. Namibia today and Namibia at independence are worlds apart. Over a period of 22 years, we have reduced poverty from a baseline of 70% down to 18%. 95% of school-aged children attend school, and the number of teachers have increased by 30%. The health system in Namibia has transformed from fragmented, racially segregated infrastructure into a more inclusive national service, catering for the health and welfare of all Namibians. The bitumen road network has increased by 45% since independence. Today, as we commemorate the milestone of our Pearl Jubilee, we do so with a sense of humility and introspection. We look up towards the horizon with hope and expectation. We look back with pride at 3 decades of peace, unity, and stability. Fellow Namibians, we have to continue our journey of social cohesion through the policy of national reconciliation. We have to continue our journey of representative government, buttressed by a sound government architecture, which upholds the principles of accountability and transparency. We have to continue to build on our gains in the fight for social progression, to uplift more Namibians out of poverty and inequality. We have to continue with determination to consolidate a robust macroeconomic environment where the fundamentals for growth and development are in place. Segments of our population continue to live in deplorable conditions without access to basic amenities. There are Namibians who are at risk of hunger, poverty, and succumbing to treatable diseases. A worrying number of our young people cannot access employment opportunities. A society that is structurally unequal can never last forever. Although the odds appear to be stacked against us, we will summon the courage and ingenuity to continue the work we have commenced with a sense of unity and common purpose. Fellow Namibians, through democratic elections, you have once again placed your confidence in the Swapo Party and I to deliver on our national development objectives. We have entered into a social contract with you, and this is the contract we will honor. Our success depends on your active participation as citizens. You have a responsibility to contribute towards the construct of a united, inclusive, and prosperous house. Yeah.